Hello all my share bears. Today's video is another Project Pan Roulette, Rolling Roulette update. That's a hard line to put out there. So, this will be update number 2. I am doing updates quite frequently because as I run out of products, I want to keep putting new products in. So, as I'm running out of things or deciding I really don't like this, it's going out, I can't handle it anymore, I'm needing to put more stuff in. So let's get on to the project and I will show you where I have gotten on these things. So the first thing in here was a Kat Von D product, and that is the liquid lipstick in Lovesick. When I started this, it was about here. Now it is about here. I really do like this lipstick, but I am finding it is drying my lips out really, really bad, and I think it's because it's been like minus 40 here at times with the wind chill. So this has been quite a feat to get that far down. So I got about that much done, but I do really enjoy this lipstick and I am keeping it in the pan, but I don't know if I will be using it over the next little while until it warms up or something, because the dryness is killing me. The next one is Tartlets in Bloom palette, which is product from Tarte. I want to hit pan on to. I am nowhere near it. These are the two I'm working on. There is significant difference in this one, but even using this every day, it is taking quite a while. Also, this pan is threatening to pop out, which is scaring me. So, am loving this palette. There is a dip now in the Sweetheart, but it's not noticeable, I don't think, to the camera. But this one definitely has a dip, and there's shimmer everywhere in this palette. So I am really enjoying that. It is staying in. That is my favorite palette of all time. So it's no surprise that it would be staying in there. The next item was a face product, and I chose the Murad Primer, Invisible Blur Primer. And I said that if this isn't done by the end of March, it's going anyway because that's when it expires. It's done. I cannot squeeze any more out. There is nothing left in there. It actually looked like there was way more in there than there actually was. And I think it's just the way the stopper was, because it pushes up from the bottom. So I'm actually really excited to get this out of my collection and add a new item. So let's check that one off as done. In the last one I told you, I hit pan on the e.l.f. blush. It is gone. Next is the Sephora Face Powder. And I have not marked this, but there was the start. There was first update, and now I am down to here. This is going relatively quickly, and there isn't much left in here, and I'm wondering if I'm even going to be able to get all of it out of here. And I still, for the life of me, cannot figure out how to open this to actually just dip my brush in it. So hopefully this will be finished by next update. It is the one I've been using exclusively, but as I said, I don't know if I'll be able to get it all out. Like, it's coming up the side there. It's actually probably a little bit further down than even that, because over here it's lower. But I have been using it. I do enjoy it. I do not enjoy the packaging. So that one is staying in the project. My next one is product from favorite high-end brand. And I chose the Makeup Forever Setting Spray. And it's gone. There's nothing left in it. If I spray, I get nothing. Like, even the tube is done. I do enjoy this. This would be something I would repurchase in a heartbeat. And it is a little bit on the pricier side, but I do like it. So there's another item into my done pile. Now on to the something purple. And this is going to be a little bit of a cheat because I do sell Avon, and I did get these masks free. So I was able to give them out as samples. I got the firming ones and I got the illuminating ones. I had given the illuminate, I had split up the package. It's a package of four. I had given them to some of my best customers, and each one. And after trying the illuminating one, they asked if they could try the firming one, which is what my something purple is. I told them, I don't know that you want to, but okay, if you enjoyed the illuminating, maybe you'll enjoy this. So I only have two. There was three left in here. I have used both these. The other one I did give to this customer because they're a good customer. So these are gone. My something purple is gone, which means I have another one to pull out. I do not enjoy these. I would not purchase these for myself. I will tell you right now, I think they are entirely too expensive for a set of four, which even if you do this only once a week, that's only a month's worth is $30 from Avon. I think that's too much for these. They, as far as I'm concerned, they didn't do anything for me except annoy me. But to each their own, I would say you can find them cheaper, even probably at Sephora. I'm just saying. But I am happy, 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 happy that's gone out of my project pan. I do not like them, but I did finish them. The next item was newest affordable. And where is it? Here it is. The item I had chosen was my Wet n Wild Blushing Bali lipstick. I'm not even going to show you any progress on this because I did not use it. As I said, I believe this is more of a late spring, early and summer color because it is coral. So I did not use this. I'm not even going to attempt to say I did. So, but I did use it at the beginning because this was a brand new lipstick. I hadn't even swatched it yet. Was an eyeliner, which I had replaced the Avon with my Mary Kay in deep brown. And I am going through that actually quite quickly. So at the beginning it was here, and now it is here. So I am doing quite well on this. I have been using it almost every day. I'm not wearing it today because this isn't a drugstore item, and I get ready with me drugstore. So this has not been used today. I normally use it in my tight line and on just above the lashes. That's it, but this is a very soft formula, so I don't see this lasting much more than a few months. But it is staying in because I do like it. Next was my foundation high end, which I did use up in the last review or update, and that was a Makeup Forever HD. The next thing was a product from CoverGirl, and I chose something that was new to me. I hadn't used it before. It's the CoverGirl Supersizer Mascara. If you see my Friday Fabs and Flubs, this made it into Flubs. I do not like this mascara. I am not going to fight this mascara any longer. I've been at this since the beginning of this project, using it every second day because it is a waterproof formula. This does nothing for my lashes. The first day I used it, it was great. The second day, it was okay. After that, all I got was, I look like I have three lashes that are really thick on each one. Plus, the stopper sucks in this. Like, it doesn't pull off enough product, so you have like a goopy mess. I'm not saying this isn't for everyone, that this is something that everybody should avoid. I don't know if it's a bad stopper. That's possible. I've had ColourPop lipsticks that have like the stoppers too loose, and that might just be the case with this. But I don't like it. It starts to flake after a few hours. I have had so much mascara in my eyes, I can't take it anymore. I am removing this from my project pan, and I can say that I have tried it and I don't like it. And I won't repurchase because I'm not going to waste money if it's not a product problem. Hello, Brina. So if you're keeping count, that's now 4 items gone. I didn't even show this in my last update because it was in my shower, which really that's where it should be if I'm going to use it. This was a body scrub, and it was the Body Shop Fuji Green Tea Body Scrub. When I started, this was new. As you can see, it's not so new, and this is deceiving because it looks like there's still quite a bit. It's actually not that much in there. I'm actually going to consider this done. I am going to finish it, but there's only like one left in it, like one application left in it. And I think why I went through this so fast is it is more of a jelly consistency. So you do use a bit more of it. Not that I don't love this product. I love this product greatly. I love the smell of it. I love Body Shop products. And I would repurchase this, just not at this time, because I do have a couple more that aren't going to go quite as fast as this one. I could tell you that, because they're more of a solid consistency, whereas this was a jelly-like consistency. So I did enjoy this. I'm going to consider it done, but I am going to finish it and it will become one of my empties. So that's done. We are now up to 5 products. Next thing is the e.l.f. lip treatment was e.l.f. exfoliator. I am doing quite well on this. I'm very happy with my progress, and I can't wait to get rid of this. This is starting to taste funky to me. So that, I was up here for the first update. Second update was here. This is my third update. I am keeping this in, not going to give up that easily, but this does it. Maybe because I just don't like the flavor of it. It tastes funny, and it is really rough on my lips, so I'm trying not to use it too often. Okay, the next item that was on my list went out on the last update, which was a bronzer, and it was just a hit pan. I said it's gone. I'm not going to keep it. I'm just decluttering it because it's old to a point where they've actually discontinued that bronzer from Avon. Then it was on to something green. It was the package that was green and the product that was green. So this is the L'Oreal Pure Clay Mask. I'm sorry, I'm not going to be able to mark this off as to where it is because I can't get in. I have long nails, so getting into this is quite a feat. I am going to consider this one also pretty much done. I am using a spatula to scrape this out because I do have long nails and it just gets underneath and then you're wasting it because you can't get it on your face, right? So I'm using a spatula to scrape it out. There is one mask left in there. That's it. I have really been enjoying this. I've been using it twice a week, sometimes three if I'm feeling like my face is a little bit oily in the T-zone, which hormonal breakouts, I have been a little bit oilier, especially in here. So I have been using it a little more frequently than I actually thought. This is pretty much done. It's like one, maybe two. So because that's like only a week worth, maybe half a week, I'm just going to consider this done and take it out, finish it, and it'll go into my empties. I really do enjoy this. If you don't like the smell of eucalyptus, you won't enjoy it. So that's another one out. That's up to six. Now we're heading into the three products I added the last time. My product from the drugstore. I chose my L'Oreal Pro Glow Infallible foundation, and I did say that this was full, and I honestly can't tell you where I am. I have been using it. I'd say I'm probably here, but there's still quite a bit of air in there. So I'm not sure. I've used this, I think, every day except twice. And even today for this, this is what I am wearing on my face today. I do really enjoy this. I believe, though, that once it becomes warmer, I will have to stop using this until it becomes colder again, because it is a glowy foundation and it does shine up quite a bit, and in the summer I just don't want that. I want something mattifying, and I think that it'd probably melt off my face, but I do really love this and it is staying in. And like I said, I don't know exactly where I am. Like, feels like there's no product from about there. So we're doing good on this. Foundation can last 3 months, so, and because this was new, I would say I'm not going to start to notice much difference for another couple weeks. The next one I picked was a Jo Fresh product, and this was another thing where I knew I was going to run out of my Murad, so I wanted another primer, and of course my drugstore primer of choice is Jo Fresh. This is not the one I normally would put in. This is the other one I got, which is an oil-free one. This was more of a cream base, whereas the mattifying one is thicker. But this, my starting point was here, and now I can see it is here. Now, This was almost brand new. I can tell you that. This was almost brand new. When you get your fresh primer, they're usually about here. So this is a case of you have way too much packaging on this. This is an ounce. It's not like it's not the size of a normal one. It is an ounce, but it's big packaging. And it will take me a while to get through this. Like I said, there I am. And when I get low enough, I actually cut off the tops of these and scrape it out with a spatula. And then my next item was newest high-end product. And I told you I hadn't even hauled this yet. So it is in a Sephora haul or a collective haul. And this is Tarte Rainforest of the Sea. And I believe it's called Sunkissed Lipstick. It's a color splash. And I have used it, but not too much. Enough to actually mark it. So I will roll it up. I will show you on here that it is still pretty much the same. Like, I've taken off the tip, but I was focusing on my Kat Von D quite a bit, so that is why this hasn't gotten much. I'm not even going to bother marking that on there. There really is no sense in marking it when it doesn't actually show that it is missing any besides like a little tip. So there is 6 items I need to choose. First number I choose is number 69, and that is something neutral. Haha. Next, number 80. I remember a product of my choice. Okay. Next one is number 73. And that is a deluxe size lip or eye product. 3 more to choose. Number 11. A product from Mary Kay. Oh my god. Number 7. Product from Art Deco. And a final one is number 48. A liquid lip. I already have a liquid lip. Okay, so these are going into my used numbers. I'm going to go away and I'll come back and I will have my new products that I am putting in this. Wish me luck, because okay, I'm back. I have chosen my products. I thought this was going to be harder than it is, but some of them were, some of them weren't. So, first one I had was something neutral. For that, I chose actually something that's new. And my goal is just to hit pan, even the slightest bit of pan, because it is new. I don't want it gone. This is the Wet n Wild single in creme brulee. I just want to hit pan. That's it. Nothing else. So I'm actually looking forward to working with this. I've heard wonderful things about that thing, that eyeshadow. The product of my choice, I chose another Wet n Wild product, and that is because my Art Deco is, or my Makeup Forever is gone, my setting spray. I chose the Wet n Wild Photo Focus setting spray. Why I chose this instead of one of my others is I actually have a backup of this in my drawer right now, and my goal is to finish it up. And I have been using it, so we're good to go. I do like it. The next one was Deluxe Lip or Eye product. I chose a lip product. This is something I've had for quite a while. It came in a set. I don't even remember how long ago I got it. I just want it out now. And this is the Fresh Honey Sugar Honey Lip Treatment, Tinted Lip Treatment. So it is tinted. This is how much I have left. This is just a deluxe size of this. These do have kind of a minty feel and taste to them. Slight color to it. Perfect for in between all my liquid lips that I have going. My next product was a product from Mary Kay. I have chosen a My Time Wise eye cream. This is almost gone, or it seems like it's almost gone. It is up here. So there isn't much left in it, but I have been using this for going on a year and a half. It takes so little. It's just like a little tiny pump, and that's all you need for both eyes. So this could take me a few weeks. I do believe it's kind of a gimme product, but it is quite a bit still in there, so I'm not going to say it's a total gimme. There is quite a bit of product still left in here, and I am looking forward to using this up before it goes bad, because these things do expire and I only have a couple months left on this. So this is a perfect time to put it in as a Mary Kay item. The next thing was a product from Art Deco. I choose to hit pan on an eyeshadow, and this is going to be a challenge because these haven't been touched that much. I am choosing to hit pan on this one. It's a pink shimmer, and that was probably the one I've used the least. So I do like these. These are soft and buttery, and I know how I will use this because I need a good brow bone highlight. So that's in there. The last item was a liquid lip. As you know, I have the Kat Von D in there, and I was like, oh god, another liquid lip. I chose one that's actually quite comfortable, and I think I can do this and actually finish it up. This is almost full, but there isn't like there's a whole lot of product in there. This is the Maybelline Color Jolt in Stripped Down. I'm wearing it on my lips today, so it speaks to it. It was either this or a liquid catsuit because I wanted something comfortable, and these are comfortable. So this is what I'm also choosing to put in. And from the looks of it, all this could have been neutral, but this is what I am choosing. I am choosing to finish it, as I said, and wish me luck, because two liquid lipsticks in the same project, this could be troublesome. So that is the end of the second update of my Project Pan Roulette. Rolling, not any end date in sight. I'm enjoying this so much. It's fun to actually get through products and feel like you've accomplished something, but I'm still shopping, so don't fear there. I hope that if you are doing this, you will let me know. I would love to check out your videos and see what kind of ideas you have for project panning. This is something I came up with by watching different videos and going, you know what, I don't want a set date. I want to do it at my own pace. And if it takes 5 years, it takes 5 years. So I hope you're having a wonderful week. Much love, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.